just existing as who you are right now, free of the desire to be someone else, and doing what must be done for the betterment of others.
It's not about you. It's about them. No man can walk out on his own story.
From the death of his ego, he can now rise and become the hero that the people need him to be. He uncovers the mayor's plan to abuse his power over the innocent for his own personal gain, stands up to death, and frees the people. Though it's a simple story, the way it presents it is what really makes the movie stand out. The film has some really trippy, surreal moments. Self-aware writing.
The hero cannot exist in a vacuum. What our story needs is an ironic, unexpected event that will propel the hero into conflict.
Humor intended for more mature audiences.
That is neat.
And witty banter between characters.
Well, you got a little something in your eye.
Well, that there's conjunctivitis. It's hereditary.
Oh, well, I'm glad to hear it's not contagious.
And though bizarre, it all works together masterfully. What surprisingly stands out about this film, besides its visual style, is the action. The action and spectacle in this film is handled so much better than that of most live-action movies that I don't know if that's really good or just sad. But regardless, I'm incredibly grateful that it exists. A sequence that perfectly showcases the action and spectacle of Rango is the canyon chase. In this 5-minute scene, you have moonshine-drinking mole people riding bats in a canyon while shooting machine guns Battlefield 1 style at our heroes trying to escape on a wagon being pulled by a boar while fighting the anthropomorphic Mad Max hordes to a western rendition of Flight of the Valkyries. And it's not just the concept of such ridiculously over-the-top things happening on screen that makes this scene amazing, but the way it's all pulled together. The cinematography, though not exclusive to just the scene, is brilliant and immersive, complete with wide sweeping shots that clearly present the action in an engaging way. The music, composed by Hans Zimmer, is adventurous and exciting. The use of character designs are amazing and clever. For example, this owl turns his head all the way around to avoid getting punched in the face. The sound design sucks you into the spectacle. And this moment where the toad is single-handedly reloading and firing a rifle at bats ridden by mole people while hanging out of the side of the wagon as the music swells is without a doubt one of the most satisfying, badass things I've ever seen in a movie. And I really mean it. I adore this sequence. It's something that's never really been done before or since, especially within the Western genre. Rango really shows that Western films don't have to rely on the tropes and cliches of the past. Sure, the film plays around with them, but it's done so in the vein of parody. And when it does uncomedically use a trope, it's done in a way that makes it really memorable moments. Besides that, Rango adds a fantasy element to the Western genre that really hasn't been explored before. Well, except for Ghost Rider. But the only things I really enjoyed about that movie was, one, Nicolas Cage, and two, the part where Sam Elliott and Cage ride off in the desert to Spider-Man's cover of Ghost Riders in the Sky. Rango, on the other hand, explores fantasy elements of the Western genre, though not to the extent of something like Dark Watch, really well, ultimately making for a world that I want to see more of. Rango is a weird movie. It's an animated talking animal Western about the search for self-identity with a gritty, unique aesthetic, unconventional character designs, eccentric humor, brilliant cinematography, a magnificent score, impressive action, and spectacle.
Idea for a video. So I opened up World Boss and I saw that Mephisto was my world
Ugh!